Yo, what is up? Big Baller Barnes back at it again. But alright, so I don't think I have an episode of My Team yet, and I don't play My Team at all. But recently, for some reason, I just been playing it, I guess because of my friends have been playing my league a lot, so I'm trying to get better at, you know, team playing and things and such. And I've probably been playing My Team for less than a week. Yeah, I think I started about like a week or so ago. And I don't know if my team's good. Some people are like, dang, for a week, that's a pretty epic team. Or maybe not. But the game has been out a good minute. So everyone basically has who they want to have. So basically, I've gotten... I did learn something. CP3 ain't really the best. I've learned some of you guys say that CP3 isn't. I don't think he's... Personally, he's my favorite player in NBA, but... I don't know, auction house, he is pretty low, so he was really the first card I was looking for, and I thought that was a decent amount for amateur player. I think I got him for like, I don't know, like 3k, which is probably could have got him even lower just because I see a lot of low sales for him. John bought another one that flipped that one. It was like probably my first flip because I was like, dang, he's selling pretty low. I probably sell him for more than, you know, what I bought him for, which I probably did something about the same amount, but I did get a little more. I did get a little out of it, you know. It wasn't anything big or anything worth, you know, keep constantly doing. And then James Harden, these are my newest additions, or these three. I just got these about a day ago. James Harden and KD and Anthony Davis. And this thing I like about my team is they're all current players. Okay, centers. Only reason I don't have an amateur center yet is because they sell for so much on the auction house. Like these guys, I got all of them probably less than 10k. All these guys less than 10k, and I just had a lot. See, the thing is, if you don't even play my team, and you want to start, like the best way I would say is really just as soon as you start, save up till you get to your collection level to 100? Yeah, 100 cards. 100 cards don't take you long at all if you keep doing domination like me. And I put it back on this screen just show you guys. Look at how little I've really done in this road to playoff seeds. There's nothing. You just have to win 3 games, and then I'm in the 8th seed. I haven't even tried playing any further because you have to play with silver, bronze player, and all that. And I'm just really not trying to use them. Gauntlet. I'm still in the same gauntlet, still with bronze, only 3 wins. I haven't really been playing that. I'm still like in the same. Well, no, I restarted it with this team I have now, with the players I have now. And challenges, I have done it. I did just 2 challenges to get I did 2 challenges just to get some my team points, because, you know, they were like, it was like 1,000, like 700, and your team didn't really need any specific criteria. And like for one of them, it was like have 6 players from the Eastern Conference and 6 players from the Western Conference, and I just so happened to have my team like that, so it just, I was able to get that win. And back to the team. Okay, so a center. So I like DeAndre. Yeah, and like Clippers is my favorite team. And Chris Paul is my favorite player. But and for the moment, I have these guys, and this is not a bad. This team will get you so far as soon as you start, and you can just start grinding on domination just to get your collection up. And then once you get to 100, you should be able to buy, you know, the first, the 1, 2, 3, and the 4 for amethyst. You can buy those players, and, you know, they can be amethyst after you get that 15K. But your center is gonna might have to wait like mine is. But even when I get enough to buy a center, it's gonna be the other DeAndre Jordan. I can't remember which was it, like throwback, or I don't remember, but the amethyst version. I don't know which one was that. And then, you know, later on, you know, I'm gonna get and even Curry, I probably could have got him for a decent price, even not lower than Paul, but I could have probably got him for somewhere near Paul, because I know everyone probably has the guy already. And even if I got him, he would be on my bench, to be honest. And LeBron most likely would too. Just really, I had to see game after gameplay, because I do like KD. I like LeBron better, but on here, I like KD better. In real life, I like LeBron better, but I hear KD. And then my whole team, the thing I like about it is I like all the players on it. You know, I actually like these guys in real life. And let me show you guys my bench. These are just some good guys I happen to have. When I first started with my team, you know, they automatically give you Jordan if you had the Jordan version. Drummond, I just got him, newest addition to the team. Does it pretty well already. Really, if I didn't like Jordan so much, I probably would have Drummond on it, because he's a way better free throw shooter. And but Jordan, I don't know, he's like, I've never seen him miss a dunk. So like Lopez, he's not bad either. Dragic, I didn't know how good he was. I think he even has I'm not gonna say a diamond card, but I did see him. I know he has an amethyst card, but I don't think he has a diamond card. Bucky Williams and JJ Redick and these two, Harrison and Kukoc. I don't know how you say it. Kukoc. And Redick's been on the team since, you know, I started, because the first team, what's your team and all that stuff was, I had picked Clippers, so they gave me him, which he's been in this a long, you know, he's been killing it with the threes, you know, even though I got all these gold and amateur players now, like, I still keep him around, like, and he just sent him in the game when I did three, like, he can just get those, I just, like, he just makes them crazy, like, better than most of my amateur players. And then also another advantage to when you do start the collection, you can get you unlock these before you can get your 15K. You better edit your own jerseys, and your own court. This in logo. I think the court is, it is before you get the 15K. But you will get these items, which are pretty cool. You know, you don't have to go off, you know, the any other team's logos or jerseys. And then you can in reality sell all of your jerseys if you wanted to, because you now have your own custom. But the thing is, I don't want to I'm really, again, like I said, keep building your collection, and you would also get these higher level unlocks. A lot of people said this takes time, but like at the same time, I want good players and all that, but I also at the same time don't want to sell all of my players, because at the end I think it would be worth it to have all. It'd be pretty cool to have the whole collection and everyone, you know. Cause once I get a whole team of amethyst players and a few. I mean, I really want a diamond player. If I get a diamond player, that would be pretty nice. And like, I wouldn't really grind for any diamond players, but once I get a whole team of amethyst players, I would actually like build up my collection. I would go in the auction house and buy like bronze, silver, you know, all these players. I would buy all of them just to fill up my collection levels. And then once I get high enough to like where I'm getting, you know, once again, you're unlocking, you know, you're even unlocking these gold cards, and I believe you have them forever. So once you get them, you can sell these cards in the auction house. Penny Hardaway. I mean, you can get all these guys. Ooh, amethyst. Like, and then you start getting amethyst players later on. Diamond Michael Jordan. Golly, that is that guy right here. He's probably 99, I believe. But yeah, you just save up. Look, you just get diamond. Like, at the finals, you're just getting diamond players. You have nothing to lose by saving. This one, I'm like, why are you? This is how people be trying to get quick. MT is by they sell their players. But we're not. I'm just here just to really play around. I was just explaining some of the stuff I've been doing. I haven't been playing this long. But I really just, you know, this video is really just for me to play a couple matches on domination and nothing much else. But I just want to show you guys some of the things I've been just thinking and realizing. And I've not been playing my team in long at all. You guys may be thinking, nah, man, sell all your jerseys, sell all your low-ranked players and all of that. But the thing is, I do sell them. I don't sell the ones I don't have. I sell the ones I have duplicates of. And you do sell a lot of people like, oh, no, man, you might as well quick sell those. I put those straight in the auction house, and they will eventually get sold, like, you know, say, like, a bronze logo or something like that. Like, it will eventually get sold for $250, like, no matter. I pick gold. I pick everything I have duplicates of at $250 in the auction house, and it will get sold. Trust me, I've... It's not gonna be instant, but it over like a course of, you know, a week or so, you should have sold like everything you've gathered on like the beginning of that week or whatever. But yeah, like so Jordan and my team is so versatile. Like, it's like everyone on it, except I would say Jordan can shoot. AD can shoot. I almost shot with him there just because I wanted to prove a point. But he can dribble. There's nothing I like about AD.
Anthony Davis is out there with
Jordan. Oh, you messed up.
Then it's Durant. Then it's Chris Paul.
And everyone on my team can do that. That is what I love. Like, anyone, everyone on my team can hit a fast. Like, I would never try anything like that in part. I used to think things like that were, like, were crazy. I was like, I'm such a part player that, like, move. I'm not even used to using moves like that. I'm like, and I'm not used to having a center. I'm used to all of it now. I've been playing this for a good minute, so I'm used to a little bit of team ball now. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. I hate it. Like, it's like sometimes you see an open lane, and then, like, sometimes a player will move a certain way, and, like, just he just gets the ball. Like, it makes the pass go right to, like, an opponent. Or, like, or an opponent moves at the last second, and that causes the. I'm sad we're not on my court this time. But it's all good. My court really ain't. I didn't try too hard on editing it.
On defense, Toronto.
Can you get this ball? And one, as long as you got the foul. I would have rather have Paul take the ball down and then Harden taking the shot. Or I could have had Paul do a pull up. I already knew he could make his free throws. That's why I wasn't even worried about how it went. He was either gonna get an and one or. We're gonna make it like it was no option. If he just straight up missed it, then you know we'd have a problem. He'd been off the team. But I do really want to get that other CP3. But he's pretty expensive. Like, he's not even a diamond card or nothing like that. But his the price I see for him might as well be diamond. Oh, I thought he was gonna. That right there was ridiculous, Jordan. Come on now. See, this why you're only. This why you're still a gold player.
Now here's Scola. Following the miss by DeAndre Jordan. Scola kicks to Carroll. And stolen by Jordan. Here's Harden. Rips down the
Euro step.
Slam.
Or was, I don't know what that. That might have just been a dunk. I sometimes end up. I sometimes accidentally do fadeaways. And I try. In Euro steps. Like when I try to do a fadeaway, I sometimes end up doing a Euro step. When I try to do a Euro step, I end up doing a fadeaway. But mostly it's when I try to do a Euro step, I do a fadeaway. But.
Stolen by
oh
Harden.
My God!
And it's Memphis on the break. Durant's running.
And one or something, Paul. Come on. Ah, that's why I usually never do that combination where Paul is the one finishing. Because Paul, like again, he gets blocked easily inside, and unless he's really open. Only time he really makes it is if another point guard is guarding him or such.
No one in clear control yet. And guys, I think each team
look at that, NY. Look, he can't finish over big man. That's the part. That was I couldn't make the shot any better. I could have probably faded away, and that would have made it. But there's nothing I don't really like about my team is the lane closes out quick on you. Like you could get open or anything like that.
That's a good way to start things off.
Whoever you're. No, that should be anyway.
Good work.
Oh, I didn't even look at the score. I need to really actually come back on him. If I actually have to really, really pay close attention, I might have to even stop talking for a minute. But we're doing good on defense. And until they start making bull like that. And I have no three. That's another problem. I have to. My whole team has to just really score inside because there's no really 3-point shooters on it.
Now the pass to Durant. Harden outside.
I did not mean that. I meant the pump fake that. I did not mean it, because he probably actually made it if I had released it right. But I was trying to pump fake, and that's why I had to short release. And that's all. Oh my god. Alright, I had to get serious. I just destroyed who I forgot who was right before these guys, but I just destroyed them. Clark, some tough offensive sets. They messed up. They cleared out the just to regain some momentum here, Kevin. They cleared out the inside. I wanted the drove, but I knew I could get him with that little spin away. But let me actually hush real quick. I need to focus on this.
Here's Lowry, and there's the whistle, fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for Toronto.
Well, I like the fact they've already been getting a lot of high-quality shots in the paint.
And also another aspect of their game that's been super.
Well, did he miss both of those? Okay, Jordan, for a gold player, that's why I know when he gets to a silver. Oh, how's that? How is that not a block? I mean, how's that not a foul?
Ross has checked in for Damari Carroll, and it's Joseph in for DeMar DeRozan.
And he usually cannot shoot like that, but I knew I was open. I know his release well enough, but he can't. He's not really. If I had the amethyst version, I know I would actually take this shot more often. But like, yeah, that's the thing. Like,
just five to shoot.
Like KD, what's his name? Harden. I can't remember his name for a second. KD and Harden can't really score outside. They can score outside when needed or when open. Oh,
certainly a good sign for them going forward.
Now here's Drummond.
When needed to, they can actually get, you know, some shots, you know. Well, I ain't gonna lie, Harden can. No, I don't know. They're pretty even. To me, they're in almost every aspect, or the way I use them, I guess they're pretty even. Cause I always make them both use the fadeaway, spin arounds, and I both. They both. Okay, here we go. Nope. And this guy, he's good, but he's slow for a small forward.
Outside for Jordan.
Ah, see, like that. Like, come on now. It would have been a good look for Jordan, even though he can't shoot threes or even that deep.
Just carelessness there. I mean, you have,
but he can make some definitely fadeaways and some spin around jumpers. But this one guy, he's pretty high, but like, I use him in like Gauntlet and like, you know, things of that nature. But like, when it comes to here in domination, he just. He can't really do much. He can do much, but can't really do much anything because it's his speed, I guess. He's like a slower LeBron, I guess you could say.
Johnson. Five on the clock.
Because he can shoot when open. I've green lighted with him from a three. I can't even do that with KD Harden or Paul.
Either team able to build much of a lead up to this point as we start the second quarter. And for Memphis guys, what jumps out to you?
He really can jam it. Like, if you leave him any space at all, he'd jam it like a center. And he could, like, this is on a draw. Like, he can do basically everything, but just can't really. He just did that at speed.
Then it's Terrence Ross.
Oh, no, I hate when they do this thing. Hate when they pit.
That's the group for Toronto to start the second quarter.
Ooh, he gave me a little too much space. Should I take this? Nah, he closing out.
Back to Drummond. Ooh. Marvelous lead pass, and he throws it down.
Ooh.
Solid on the one hand throw down there.
Because JJ Redick can actually make some surprising stuff for a silver card. It's probably one of the best silver cards. I would even, like, even if I had a whole amethyst, I might even just keep using him because I do need a three scorer.
Toronto working the ball around now.
No, I gotta check. If they got a gold card for him, I would really get that. Very often.
The better to be lucky than good sometimes. Fortunately, they didn't get burned on that one.
Back to Dragic, 14 feet away. Here's Drummond.
The rebound, boy.
The rebound. With a nice jam.
And that's an example.
Up at the bench, I hate it when
I'm grabbing the offensive rebound and then going back up strong.
And GA in a close game like this, where every possession,
I hate it when I try to pit my starters with my bench players. I only like to have my starters in when there's other starters in.
Two big points for them off that miss.
Here's Redick. after Toronto got the three-pointer.
Oh, Drummond hot right now.
And we're a little over a minute and a half.
I hate it when they make me do the pull-up instead of, you know, going in for the layup or dunk. That pull-up really, really throws it off. Like, some players can. It is a decent amount if, like, I guess you could have, like, what is his name? If he has any shooter, I guess. Center. Okay, I ain't gonna lie. So, it's some shots, like, I do agree. Okay, here, can we get that in?
Back to Dragic. It's Durant on the wing. Back to Dragic, pass to Redick.
Oh, AD. And won that. I really could have shot that with him. Really, if his shot went so slow, and I thought the D went of like that from the three. If I think the defense would have closed out on him fast enough, I would have probably shot that. Cause he can't shoot open ones, but that's about it. He ain't gonna hit nothing. No dead eye shot or nothing like that.
Here's what Toronto's going with right now.
He gotta be completely open to make his, but he can't make them. Oh my gosh, I hate it when I can't, like, when it's that many people and you can't tell who got the rebound. And we would have been so good if we could have got that through. Come on, Drew. There we go. What? The boy jumped. That man, there's no way the man could have got back up. Even, man, I should have got the end one at least. It was no way he should have got back on me before I got the shot off.
So Jordan nails both of them.
I mean, I was going to make the free throws either way, but still, I feel like I should have got the shot off way before he even got back or was able to recover.
He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Scola sets a screen for Lowry. Outside.
Nah, he ain't going to. Yeah. 2K, Aggo.
Guys, what a tight start to the game this has been.
Let's see.
There have been 7 lead changes already, guys?
Wow.
To Harris. Look at that. Look at what I'm talking about. Like that. I don't even see centers dunk like that, but I guess you could say he has more speed for, like, and even the game knows it. He's pretty big. He's like 6'11 or something like that.
Well, it was.
Is he that big? He's pretty big. I know he's he's pretty tall. What is your name? So 6'9". Okay, I was drunk, but
they'd have a little more energy at the defensive end.
Did they like on my I guess my shooting team. He's like my 3-point scoring team. He's in a center position, so he's obviously big enough to play, you know, the five.
Taking the steal and then turning it into two.
But that's really small ball right there.
No telling how important that sequence could turn out to be.
And guys, in a game this snug, moments like that are the ones.
My starters get back. What quarter is this? And see, this is why I hate, like, you know, my AD was playing in it a little bit, so he couldn't even fully recover.
DeAndre Jordan's checked in for Lopez.
But yeah, he should be strong. I don't even like use AD. I couldn't catch
for Jordan. And Chris Paul subbed in.
Oh, we good. Oh, AD, my fault for denying you, my guy. My fault for denying that I didn't need you. I take it all back.
Guys, this one is threatening to get.
And as everyone probably knows, because everyone I've seen basically has completed domination. Like when I watch a YouTube video over my team or anything like that, I basically see that they've completed like almost the domination. So most people know to go ahead and do this, because I know everyone knows you get like a decent amount out of it, and like you can redo it. Like sometimes, like if you really want it, snap. Listen, I would actually be mad at 2K if they didn't go in.
The defense a step slow, and you can see the result.
Greg, that's 3 in a row from out there now, so they've got to do
it. I tried
to
air one on my team. Just
and here is Durant following Kyle Lowry's 3. Durant.
I should have went for it. I should have stayed with the dunk. I didn't think he was going to dunk. I thought he was going to go look for later. See, and switching up is always either a good thing or a bad thing. You can, if you, I was about to say, it better get out. If you switch up a shot, you know, it usually can make it better, or it can give you the and one or foul. I thought AD was going to go straight.
He feeds it to Davis. Back to Paul. Some nice passing there by Memphis. Here's Durant. pass to Jordan.
Get the foul. Oh, my. I would not take no shot like that with the man if I went. I don't. Well, he wouldn't even make the free throws anyway. This is only drawback to free throws.
Another miss by
thank you, 2K. You actually helped me out today. Use your B-Bull on winning.
Not as aggressive.
Okay. They've got to keep I meant to do a spin. Inside, oh, here you go.
Offensively. Good. And Memphis leads by four.
That was the third straight high percentage look this defense has allowed. I mean, these defenders have got to start.
And D-Wade isn't also a bad shooting guard either. He probably basically does the same thing as Harden. I got to do a little research on that. The players I have are really probably one of the cheapest amethyst players for their position because they are the current versions of their players. You know, these are all good players in real life, but I guess they're saying their current versions aren't the best versions of themselves.
Right side Durant.
That's basically what they're telling me. Oh, dang, I didn't know. I did not know I would have shot that with, I would have been past the point and let him shot that because he was a little open. Ooh. Oh, I thought. It said my three-pointer. Wait, did I even shoot a three? Who did I shoot a three with?
We have a post-ball game on
I don't even remember shooting it. Oh, what's his name? Shot a three. Drogic.
Toronto trails by four. Checking out the group for Stan Van Gundy to start the second
half. I try to time it just right and have my starter switch out at,
And it's Paul in
at this way you had actually have a, the way I play I have to
aggressive move too kept trying to send a
shoot,
message
I thought he was
a
shooter behind me
I
was ready
sure
to pull
it was text or email but he definitely threw that one down
Davis look at that that boy can shoot dunk he can do it all if he really could never mind good but if I really wanted a big team I actually put him at the I think he probably is at the three on my tall team I have to check that oh this has been a block you got chase oh no chase down ain't gonna work on here they could probably easy be blocking her dudes on her probably look at his average blocks on my I don't know if it works like that. If it would show your stats for the my team season, I ain't really looking too far into anything like that. But if I go to my player, I wonder will it show all that. Oh, good.
Down low, here's Harden.
Paul, how you gonna? And one, yeah, good stuff. Paul, how you gonna let him make a pass like that? But you can make this simple pass.
Not phased at all by having a bigger defender on him down low.
And that's another thing. I usually don't I usually do when my point guard's best shoot threes, which he can, Paul can, but I usually mainly want him for passing to make them deep passes like this.
And Durant, here we go.
Oh, let me take that. Oh, I thought that was in there. I thought that was good. I think it was because I hesitated. I wasn't going to take it at first, and I saw how open he actually was.
Memphis leading by four.
Oh, I could have.
Durant with a wide open look.
Can't really get not really a shooter. I gave him okay. I gave him a corner specialist, so he should be making something. Like I said, not a really 3-point shooting team, as I told you guys earlier. And defensive wise, I guess I'm talking to you guys. I've really been messing up on defense with Paul. I usually a better defender with Paul. I mean, really at this point guard running around me a bit. I'll get that. It's hard to know which centers can shoot, so you don't know which center should you actually just try to foul.
Closer and closer to crunch time. You're right, Clark. Just continue to
you messed up.
In the paint and get those
you messed up. The boy can't. The boy can shoot the open ones, but you know. He ain't making no career pull-ups or nothing like that.
Looking to run away.
And as long as your boy will get those though. I forgot you can freaking buy badges on the thing. My God, I'm finna give everyone on my team Dimer. Oh, I was not. I forgot all about you could buy badges. Can't wait. You can't buy badges, right? I can't even remember. Okay, yeah, but for remaining of the game, I'm gonna leave my starters on the bench. Well, I'm not gonna leave them the whole game, but I'm leaving them on the game to like after 5 minutes of the fourth quarter. Like, come on, if they pass, get this stuff. I'm glad Jordan went in. I know he can make his free throw. Who did Lopez? I know you can make yours. You ain't Drummond, but you can make yours. Drummond really be making his free throw. He's shooting like a point guard, but I know any center on my team but Jordan can make his. That's the only reason I'm questioning his liability on the starting lineup, but Because I usually at the end of, at the if it's a close game, I usually got to take him out. He takes it up and lays it in. But you know, that's why all my other positions aren't really that great, but I got three good centers, and that's because that's the only position I don't have an amateur player in. So I just got three good back. I got two more good backup centers that are all gold, which you know helps me out and helps me out in the long run. Bucky here, Bucky. What are you doing, my boy William? Right here, when he was on the starting lineup, he used to actually put some work in for a gold card.
Patrick Patterson picking up that last bucket. Williams.
Yep, is he was outside
for Jordan. In the third quarter, with just over
that was a little too deep for him. But if that was by KD or Harden, they would have got that. But he can make it. And when I first started using Jordan, I was like, man, he's the only gold card when I first started using him. I was like, man, he's letting me down because he can't really shoot. He can't for a 3-point shooter. For his three, even though it's like 50 something, he can actually make them over. But what the guy really can do is other things like floaters, and he can make probably any open midi. But like, look, he makes things like that. Oh my God, he missed it. But this really mainly stuff like that is good for him. Like that, any switch up, he's usually the main one getting the N1s on my team. What was when he used to be in the starting lineup. And it's the thing, like you, when the more you move on, the actually your bench isn't getting weaker at all. I mean, well, of course your bench is getting better, but like you still know how to play. Like your bench isn't holding you back at all because you're gonna know how to play with them because they're gonna be the same cards you used to have. Like even if I was getting all diamond players, I would still have the same. My bench would be the same as my starting lineup now, so it wouldn't even hold me back at all. Like I would probably even have my bench in more often than I do now. But maybe not. I don't know. They might let me down. But players I'm really looking to get, I'm gonna look into JJ Redick, see if he got a gold card. He probably got some throwback third. He probably got something. I know he got something. I know he got something.
I mean, he's not a player you can leave open for a jump shot.
He messed up. Hey, he didn't go for the pump. Oh, this ain't the. I thought this was oh, wait, what the world? I gotta call timeout. I don't know what my team, what the who, I don't know what the computer's doing with my rotation right now. But I'm gonna have to change.
Shot clock at six. Deep two from Ross. Good as the jump shot falls.
And really, if I wasn't trying to focus on what I was saying and things of that nature, I really would be just blowing these guys out. But
also the body movement off the ball that's created a lot of those opportunities. Yeah, I think he just sees some things that can be improved and wants to get everybody back on the same page.
I used to keep my like stuff on manual, like timeouts and stuff, but I realized that sometimes they try to put my start. Nah, my starters can. What quarter is this? The first for Memphis. How much time we got? I have to throw my starters in. We got 30. I throw them in for the rest of this. DeMar DeRozan. And then when the fourth quarter starts, I will switch him out. Oh, I forgot. I thought they.
29 seconds left in the third.
Look, he don't really like powerful probably handles on him. I ain't gonna say. Ooh, nice pass.
Six to shoot. Outside Durant. And the wide open
Let's go. I saw him so late. I was about to just Durant take the fader. I didn't even think I had enough time for him to get the shot off. But he, Paul will make them jumps. This is what people don't understand. I don't know why he's so low on the thing. He can. He's so good. I just don't. Real life on a game. Okay, now I'm finna throw my bench players in for a good. Oh, my star is still at 100. What should I do? If I put, it made me automatically. But if these guys, I'm gonna have to leave these guys in the rest of the cold game. But and he can just make the pass. Like, shoot, I thought he was if I had passed there earlier.
Then it's Damari Carroll and it's Scola in at the four. So that's the five in the game for Toronto. Where you at, KD? Now here's Durant. Shot clock at five. Paul outside. Harden against DeRozan.
And nothing fancy really about that play. That's just good old-fashioned hard-nosed basketball to get that one.
And lately, CP3 been getting the MVP on my team a lot. KD usually, he, I don't know, KD usually always has, like, he throws it, hits and plenty of work. I think that's a drawback on having, I think home teams actually do worse on free throw shooting. Because, you know, it ain't no little thing. But I guess they're, like, graded harder on you because, like, y'all missed up. Oh, what? There's no way they could close that on me that quick. And look, I don't even want this dude shooting free throws. He gonna miss one, no matter what. Look at that. That wasn't even like a bad one, but he just make the free throw look so bad. I know that one right on the line or not, but he just make them just look that. Like, hey, he missed the right on the line. Dang, he like, you don't even, every time he give, even when I get an and one, I'm not even happy. I already know it's. Here you go, Euro step on him. A floater, either one. See, that's what I meant when I say I sometimes be trying to Euro step and end up hitting a floater. But usually when I do it, it still works either way.
Outside DeRozan. Carroll passes to Lowry.
See, and I probably would have missed any layup I took if it went a Euro step though. This is another good thing.
Played in with a nice touch off the glass.
Oh, actually, shoot, okay. What y'all at? Really, look, I'm going to throw my bench in for a good minute after this position.
By four. Ball outside. Final quarter here, and we're just over a minute and a half through it. Outside, Davis. Clock at six. He kicks it to Durant. Takes a shot at the elbow. That's good. And Memphis leads by six.
If they will make that consistently, if they're not in your face, I mean to say, if it's no real defensive contestant. I don't even know what you would say, like contestation. If it's nothing, no one really contesting the shot, then you can pretty much. And like, you don't even like, I don't even know everyone's shot on my team. I know Reddick's, I know Paul's, I know Harden's. I'd say I know everyone's except
Toronto making a change here. Ross is checked in, moving it up.
Dang, that pass sucked, but he. Ah, Drag, you supposed to make those. Okay. Yes, there's sometimes it can either the change up can kill you or help you, you know. Sometimes blocks would turn into fouls. Okay, can you get that pass? See, look, if he was any quicker, he would have had that. But like, what? That's supposed to be all you do. That's what I'm talking about when these gold players ain't, you know, pinned up like they're supposed to. I'm getting a little too used to Anthony's players. I know I used to.
Now the dish to DeRozan.
I hear silver player. I forgot. He is silver. Okay, they make that. I'm not even mad about the pass. I just shot him. If it was a goal, though, he definitely had that one. But I ain't even mad at Draghi. He was a point guard. He good. Y'all both good. Ain't gonna trip.
Jordan kicks to Williams. Back to Jordan.
Oop, he's so quick. That's what I like about Jordan. Quick. Hey, dude, why would you go?
Drives in.
Oh, I need to actually get serious. We've been playing around, but like my defense has been like that. I'm gonna drive you a point guard.
No clue where that pass was going. That is a brutal turnover.
Well, look at the clock. A little under 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth. Clark, some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, they need a basket just to regain some momentum here, Kevin.
Ross with a wide open look from outside off the mark. Memphis leading by four. It's Jordan on the wing.
Oh, that pass was so risky. Oh, what am I doing? I only want these guys playing for a little minute. Dang.
You can see the eye contact there. Gave a little nod.
And I'm starting. I just want those dudes to play for just 4 minutes. I ain't saying that them first play like the full 3 minutes. Well, we were messing up. Wait, did I put him in? Okay, I did. I was going to say that.
So Memphis ends up going with the new group.
Talking about, look at those crisp passes, draw. Just take note. Take note. This is what a true point guard looks like. And I usually like to play, what is it? I think they call it off ball D, or I don't know what they call it. Eat that. Get them loose balls. Eat that. Look, like, I hate, like, we playing such good defense, and then, like, things like that happen, like they'll lose the ball, but it actually just always gives, it seems to always give them a better look. Every time someone loses a ball on her and you don't pick it up, it just seems like it gives the whole team a better look at the goal.
Of course, he didn't have an attempt there in the first half. He's hoping to be a little bit more active and aggressive here and draw some fouls here in the second. Now here's
Durant from 15. Oh, that might have been, okay, never mind. I forgot who I had. ADR. I was like, the pad, the shot was a little risky for a power forward, but I forgot who I had on it. I was like, he gonna be open when he get the ball, but I don't know if shooting it quick is the best option. That's what I'm talking about. To me, it ain't Love. I forgot about Love. It ain't really too many better. I don't know why, but it seems like the bit. I guess they're more common. That's why they're cheaper. I'm like, these guys are better than me. Harden's better than. I don't know. In the shooting guard, Harden. I could get a better shooting guard than Harden. But for what I want for shooting guard, he's definitely what I need. Ooh, I was gonna pull it. These point guards, no. Who is it? Wrong pass. They missed. I messed up. I didn't know. I thought he was going to jump way at me for that or after that pump. But he couldn't even make it. I should just shot it. He couldn't even make it. I thought he was going to get. He was going to. You know what? Paul, you can't do this. My son. Lowry against Paul. Outside. Euro good. King. They won a Euro, but I already knew he could make it. When the help D don't come, it's like this when my team do the best. You know what I'm saying? That's a warm up for my whole team. If a D don't come on them, they just gonna go straight in and just knock it down. Or give the foul. Even if they get the foul, it's usually an angle.
53 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
Nah. See, look, it's like when I that's why I really don't like to play on ball defense. Cause like when they don't do certain things, you know, like the computer's like, you know, the computer to them, it's like they're actually in the game. But the player don't move the way I want to when I'm trying to move them. That's why you just like switch up like when it's like a shot like that. Like it's like every time the point guard gets the ball inside the paint and I have my point guard defending, it's like they always can score on them. Because I can't just like, it's like they can just move around my body. Or I don't even got to explain it. But. Come on, he's supposed to get that crossover. You on the 2K tutorial for dribbling. But you be losing it more than anyone on the team. But let's go. What? What? I probably shouldn't have did all this spinning, but I thought I was already spinning into the animation when he got knocked down. Oh, who got fouled? Did we get a free throw? A charge card, you see what I'm saying? Memphis with the ball. Oh, it's tied. Dishes it to Harden. All right. Well, I already know who I can go to anytime. Jordan, anything. The to Paul.
Back to Jordan.
I see you, AD. Now.
Davis at the elbow and stolen by Scola. Fast break, Toronto.
Don't foul. Don't foul.
Carroll with the three. No good from three-point territory.
I was wondering when my team didn't foul. I thought they had to leave for some reason. I guess okay, yeah, we can win this.
Now a timeout called by Memphis.
I'm trying to see where we start when we get the ball, though. I don't know. We'll find out. Oh, I heard. Okay, shoot, they missed it right there. Missed it.
Now off the inbound, here's Davis. Yes.
He's one of the best there is in the business when it comes to making that lead pass. See, it was a risk. I could've.
Toronto calls timeout. What do you think, guys?
Your only chance here is to lob it towards the basket and go for the tip in. There's not enough time left to catch.
Hello. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Freaking talk to someone. This the game, like, I know every time, if it was anyone else, I think they would have took a good, they extra two nanoseconds. I think that they would have missed it, because I think as soon as they went up with it, they would have took some time before they shot it. But AD went up so quick with it, this had enough time. And I could have just took the shot with Harden. I could have just went up in that Harden. Who would I have? KD. I could let KD took it. And Chris Paul always is the player of the game. Because he gets so many assists because he can't throw the ball. Like, most people can't throw the ball. Oh, yeah, he was busting a three. I forgot about that. Wait. He had how many points? That's all I got. Ooh, but I better get all stars. Okay, I better get all. I usually get 700. That's why I didn't. And I knew to get all three stars, I was like somewhere in the 600s. And I didn't know. I usually get 700 a game, though. That was because I was playing around and I was talking, commentating, and that's why I couldn't focus completely. But yeah, I was still able to come through with this. It was a really fun game, though. It was a really fun game, but like you could tell the whole time I could have just blew him out if I really wanted to try hard. But, 8 points. Okay, let me. I know he shot two. Okay, he did make 2 threes. I thought he had 5 points for something. Like, I know this man shot 2 threes. Not. And then he made. Your boy was busting today. That's all I ask for a point guard. Like, I don't need you to pull up on threes. I just need you when you open for a three, just make that jump. And just, you know, that's what he does. He can make. I almost want to say anything, but. Layups, he gets blocked so easily. Like, if any help defense comes, he's usually getting missing or getting blocked. And it's rare. Well, he gets the fouls, but I feel like, you know how Curry gets fouls in real life. I feel like he don't get the fouls he deserves. But yeah, that was, since I took so long, I guess we can open these cards and I'll explain. I would play two games. This part, what we're usually going to do is play two games. And I realized now you can go buy badges. So I'm finna go buy some badges, some Dimer badges, and get everyone on my team Dimer. So just to make shoot everyone gold Dimer. That's an idea right there. If you didn't even think of that yourself, but I forgot all about that. I was like, man, I need to get. I wish they offered you way more badges. So you know, cause I'd be actually adding these on my player. I usually wait. I was waiting to get a team like this before I started adding badges, which I'm starting to have. Dang, that gave me DeRozan. Okay. That's what I was waiting for. And look, this is what I meant. Look, when I get duplicates, all I do, you will eventually sell this. Like, look, by next episode, these will be sold. I don't quick sell anything. By next episode, you will not see these three cards. You might not even see this one. But I guarantee you, these been on auction a good minute. People will buy them. People are actually trying to fill up their collections. Some people don't care, just try to quick sell everything. You know, you can actually, the amount of people that quick sell keeps it balanced. If no one quick sell and everyone see everything auction, then there's no way you would probably sell any of this. But since there's so many people that just quick sell, you know, things because they think they can't get it sold, but you gotta have a little patience. This won't, you know, I will eventually, like, over time, everything I didn't quick sell and just sent to the auction will probably eventually pile up. And I won't even realize how much I saved or gained, I should say. Through it, but yeah, I would usually play another game, but since I did so much explaining at the beginning of the episode, I won't even worry about it. But let's check on something though. Crawford. Okay, let me show you guys. Jamal Crawford is like the only player I know that has like a silver to diamond card. I don't know anyone else that has a silver to diamond card. I'll pull him up real quick. See, he has this card right here, a diamond. I didn't even know he had this one. This one, he was on the Warriors back in the day. This one, 2014, his gold card, his silver card, the regular current card, I was about to say. I don't know what that six means. What is it? I don't. It's not explaining, but And then here says, this year, you know, I don't see how they really should have made his current card a gold card. Well, I guess when the game came out 2015, this one sent 2016. So in 2016, Carl wasn't in the game originally. I guess you could say. So I guess because he did so well, they put him in. They gave him. And this card here is what I really want, but Harden. I think Harden. I think he's just so common. Because if you look at the stat wise, Harden is way better. But I really wanted a 3-point shooter, but Harden is just so much better in every other aspect. That's why I really kept him. And he has another silver card and another gold. This man has to have the most cards out of anyone I know. He has different variations of cards. He has two gold cards, an amethyst card and a platinum card and a silver card. But yeah, that was all I want to show you guys. And let me look in the auction house real quick and see if we can actually buy. I know you can buy some. What are ball cards? No, that's not what I'm looking for. Consumables. I think that's it. Yeah, badges. Okay. Yeah, you can. Okay, this is what I believe. I was thinking. But dang, man. What the heck? What is this? I was like, what badge could you offer for that much? But you can't actually, if you're not really a badge guy, you could really offer some, you know, good badges. I didn't really think that they would have badges like I definitely want everyone on my team to have Lob City finisher, because I throw so many lobs, and I do actually want everyone to have Lob City passer. I might even have DeAndre Jordan start throwing the lobs, which I've never even just thought of, but I only see finishers, so I don't see any passes. But I'm finna put the filter on and let's put the filter on and I don't see Lopsy finish. I'm finna put the filter on so I don't have to see those high. I'm not trying to pay no thousand for any badge card. But yeah, I might. The lowest I'm gonna pay. What's the minimum? Yeah, that's probably what I'm gonna pay for the maximum buy is 25. But yeah, alright guys, thank you for watching. If you enjoy, and we'll be having more episodes, please hit that subscribe. I'm just giving you tips. I'm realizing I don't, like, you know, some people might not even realize some of the things I've said, but like, I've only been playing this for like a week now, and you know, I just started up on it, so I'm not just the best yet. And you saw, like, if you thought like my gameplay was like, dang, he can't really play that good as a team or whatever. I didn't throw nearly, because I guess the rotation, every time like someone was on a fast break, it usually was Paul finishing. I usually throw so many lobs, because usually running the two always running down would be Harden and what's his name? I can't even think. KD, Harden and Durant, they usually be running down, so they usually one they vice versa, they lob to each other. One finishes and sometimes the other throws, the other one throws. But normally they're the two running down, of course, so they usually finish it. But I actually had a chance where Anthony Davis actually had got a lob finish. Usually they're so slow, they're usually not even nowhere near when I throw the lob. But Chris Paul, and usually when I have Paul, man, and I see someone coming down, like usually KD or Harden, and I'm at like half court, I'm throwing a lob when I got Paul on me, and he usually makes those mostly. And then I made sure I gave them two lob city finisher. At first Harden used to miss a couple of lobs because he didn't have the lob city finisher. Now he has it, and KD has gold lob city finisher now, so he usually does a flashy dunk now when he dunks it. But if you did enjoy, please hit that subscribe. You know, I have plenty of like small tips you might not even realize, and what I've been doing, you know, in on here, you know, just to make some EVC. If you thought my team was good, I haven't, you know, done anything. I had a couple of, when I first started playing this, you know, it was nothing, or you know, I was completely, you know, I'm a legend of Park and all that good stuff, so. I had enough VC to buy this one when it first came out, this second chance box. So I bought this with VC. That's why I'm solo on VC now. I haven't been playing anything since I got on my team, but I had enough VC to buy this, and it just gave me a little start, but it didn't give me no It didn't give me any Amethyst players. I bought all of those myself. But it gave me, I don't know if I should risk buying another pack. I'm trying to see if I get an Amethyst player. I gotta look up some videos on these, see if you get anything good out of any of them, or what's the chances of getting anything good. But yeah, like I said, if you enjoy watching this, please hit that subscribe, and I'm out.